these firms. We question that they review this revised scope, and that we give them the last opportunity to adjust their full scope and price. At that time, when we sent out the EPD approved scope, we said that the pricing would not alone be used to base the selection on, that it was going to be more on the completeness of the proposal to meet the scope that EPD had given us. Each one of our firms sent in revised proposals by November 7th. They were reviewed, and staff recommended that the last proposal was the most detailed, in-depth, thorough, and complete proposal, and that's met the internal requirements of the approved SCP from EPD. Some of the highlights of Austin's proposal, these are set off from the other ones, field work, while others include less field work. We believe that the field work is very important for an engineering system and gives better results in the model. They also call for disaggregating the system to increase resolution to better see what's going on for troubleshooting flows. They identified two areas to set out, task 1.4, understanding the surroundings, bottlenecks, defect identification. They incorporate land use classifications, population levels, elevations, aerial topography, and complaint locations. And then in task 2.2, they go into detail on the bottlenecks, defects, and do not assist and share bottlenecks. And so both of these tasks identify significant factors that weren't clearly identified in the proposal. And lastly, the task 1.12, They had two new master lift stations to the modeling to reflect post-construction flows in the system and to project what would happen after completion of the force rate. Our proposal cost for this work was a long estimate of $200,000. The other two firms submitted lower bids but had additional work proposed to get to $200,000. However, they preliminary costs were lower. The expenditures were open-ended to reach $200,000 and probably would have ended up requiring additional scope to be added to the, as well as more expensive. The recommendation was to award the SCP to Parsons in the amount not to exceed $200,000. The acting city questions.
I got one question.
Yes, sir.
What does GM stand for, sewer GM?
Sewer gems, it's, I forget what the gems stand for. It's there's several different types of software that they use in modeling. We have, we use water gems and sewer gems on the water and sewer system. They were first used by CDM Smith several years ago. Parsons has recently updated that model for working on a force main project, et cetera. But they're typically, there's several different types of software out there that you can use for modeling. This is just one of the one that we use.
Questions from anybody?
Just a couple. In reading into the detail of Parsons' proposal, this sounds like it's really going to provide some data that goes far beyond any kind of studies that we've done so far.
Yes, sir. That was what was impressive. We started on an initial scope. They all submitted, pricing, proposed scope to do it. And then when we finally got the approved SCP, we submitted that outdoor. And Parsons, they really changed their overall scope once they saw what EPD was doing and wanted. And like I said, it was both complete and detailed and ready a lot more, I think, for the back of the block part.
Those are my words exactly. It sounds like it's going to be a very great thing. Considering that so much of that area where we've experienced the biggest problems is both mine and Robert's district, when I read this and took the time to read the details of their proposal, I was thinking, okay, now, anybody wants to come up when this thing is done and say, we haven't done our homework. This is no bigger homework. But my last question, and then I'll shut up. How long do you think it's going to take you to do this?
I've been